Hi Leo, it's Jackie B here. It's so nice to be here in your energy. I was just thinking about your beautiful evolved energy and like just your desires, the desires that you have for such good, kind, loving things. You just have an amazing heart, Leo. And I just wanted to stop in for a second and say that. This is your reading for June 2021. For those who are returning, thank you for being here. I mean, like, I'm so grateful that you're here and so grateful for your support on this channel. And for those who are new, I am Jackie B. I am an intuitive, a light worker, and a manifesting mentor. And I'm just going to crack on with your June 2021 reading. It's general, it may not resonate for everybody. If it doesn't resonate, be sure to check out your sun, moon, rising, and Venus. All right, let's get started. Oh, bit of a shuffle. That's spirit. All right, are we good? Is it hot? It's not hot. All right, you let me know when it's hot, spirit. Past, present, future energy, my beautiful neighbors. The kids that live next door are like doing, it's autumn here in New Zealand. If you're not in New Zealand, all the leaves are falling from the trees. And so they're out the front, like after school jobs, like leaf blowing all the leaves and all that. They're just so beautiful. But there is noise in the background and that's what it is. But we work with that, right? Real life videos. All right. We are. It's hot, Leo. She's hot. I tell you what, the energy, I tell you what, there is just, you are manifesting something in particular, and I tell you that it is coming. I tell you that it is coming. Past energy is talking about you healing past pain, literally, and some of it is generational pain. So your past energy is the time machine. And that time machine energy, oh no, it's daddy. Oh no, it's dad. Dad's getting in there, sorting it out. I love it because they do mine as well. It's just like, oh, thanks guys, I just love you guys. I have the best neighbors in the world. Moving right along. Generational. Generational past pain. Like, you guys have closed down generational pain. You've done, like, for some of you, you feel like you haven't quite, because of the perfect, in perfect harmony. Oh, that's not what I thought it was. Bear with me, Leo. This is a very amazing, beautiful, powerful reading. The cards here are just amazing. And now that I see this card, I thought it was something else, but it's not. This is, holy shit, balls of fire. So past energy, closing down cycles, like generational cycles. Literally, time machine, going back in time and fixing some stuff. And that was your past journey. And it was a very brave journey. Very, very brave. Like, some of the things that you're doing currently in your present energy is very, very brave. Like, you're being courageous and brave, and you're listening to your heart, and you're allowing your heart to call some of the shots. And that is bang on, because what you do by the choices that you've made, the courageous moves that you made, being brave, you know, and you, it's you're making these decisions now because you've closed down past like limiting beliefs and fears, and you've closed those down, or you've started healing those things. And you really have, like spirit is saying, some of those things you actually don't realize you've closed, and you've closed down some massive stuff. Generational stuff, so that your kids don't have it, and so that your kids' kids don't have it. And that, I just tell you, is such, and because of that, you've become more fierce and a really like lion energy, like strong, not fierce. You've become very, because you already are fierce, very strong energy, waking the lion. And what that means is it's a very balanced energy of somebody who is brave and makes the right moves. And you do it because waking the lion is talking about you're making moves based on your survival and the survival of the ones that you love, and surviving, not just in spirits, like, no, it's not just surviving, it's actually living your full life, and you're making some brave moves because of it. And it's brave because you're doing some of the things you wouldn't have allowed yourself to do in the past. And because you've done that, and because you've opened yourself up, Leo, like that, and you've become brave, and you've literally shaken off some old vibrational, like collateral damage, vibrational matter from your life. And because of that, you've created perfect harmony, in perfect harmony. So now you are good at so many things, and you're also good at so many things. You're good at all the things. So now, and this is future energy, it's talking about between now and like 6 months, and spirit's like, and beyond, baby. Oh, yeah. I was just thinking, which one of my guides says that? And then I'm like, I say that. That's something I say, actually. So me translating it like that. But I was like, that's somebody else. And then I was checking, and I was like, oh, yeah, I know who it is. Like, which one of my guides would say that? And I'm like, oh yeah, that one. So in perfect harmony, you closing down those cycles, more cycles than you think, has given you the confidence to do things you haven't done before. And because of that, you've opened up new frequencies and new energies, new vibrations in your life. You become a vibrational match to things that create more harmony in your life. And it says in perfect harmony. So in this future energy, the things that you attract are a perfect vibrational match to you. And some of you are like, shit, what's my vibration? So spirit's like, don't do that. You are all good. You are all good. The frequency that you have is, you're cracking me up. Whoever that energy is, you're cracking me up. That frequency and there is, that's your frequency calling it in, okay? So all the ego thoughts around it and fears and then like the little things that are still dissipating but are still lingering around, which are fun. I'm finding it more humorous than anything, is no longer the dominant energy in your life. The dominant energy is free flow. And so that's why you're bringing in a perfect harmony. And then your overall energy for June is endless possibilities. Your June energy, your overall June energy is endless possibilities, Leo. Endless possibilities. Meaning that you have the ability now to create all the things. Because we know that you're like, you say it to yourself. You are very good, say it to yourself. I am amazing at manifesting this, 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 and this. And then bring in the new ones. I am also amazing at manifesting this, this, and this. Because call it in. You are amazing at manifesting money. If money is something that you haven't manifested very well before, say it. If friendships haven't been something that you've manifested in the past, say it. If joy, if happiness, if emotional stability, if relationships, whatever. It doesn't matter, like the right job, the right kind of job, whatever. Call it in, because now you are amazing at manifesting that, because you now are in an energy field where the possibilities are endless. I'm going to clarify for you now, Leo. I'm going to pull some clarifiers from the tarot. Spirit, can I get a clarifier for Time Machine, please? What a reading, Leo. You did this. I will say this to you. You created this flow. You created this harmony because you were brave enough to face the past. And now you've become even more confident and you're starting to do things that you would never have done before. And it is opening up the gates for more harmony in your life. And for June, a lot of us, June is very powerful because we're coming out the other side of the blood moon. Some of us are still in the phase. Some of us are coming out of it and we're kicking ass. Like all the things. Thank you, Spirit. Justice in reverse. Feeling past energy. Feeling a bit shit. You know, like, so you're cutting out. You're cutting out. So the Justice is card. The Justice card's there in reverse. So the Time Machine, we're talking about the past pain. Justice in reverse, not getting the justice. The Page of Swords, cutting out the need to get justice. Because you're making peace with it yourself. And feeling also like you're making peace with the fact that some of your past, didn't end up with the happy family. and you feel ripped off by that on many levels, and you've made peace with it because you now know that you were destined for loads of other things before that, you know. And so you feel really ripped off by your past, but you let go of that. Judgment in the upright. This is talks about you getting what you deserve now. So spirit's bringing in the balance for you. So this is about everybody is in the energy field they need to be in based on what they've been through and what they're coming out of. So for some people, there's going to be a rock and roll, but for you, Leo, you're calling in perfect harmony and endless possibilities because of your bravado of dealing with that and letting go of that and not requiring the justice. You don't need people to pay for what they did because you don't want to be in the energy field anymore. You just want to move forward. You're like, screw you. If I think about you for another second, it'll screw with all the hard work that I've done coming out of this and aligning myself better, right? Tower moment. Brave. All right, Ace of Swords in reverse. So being brave, repeating mistakes. You were brave. So there was this tower moment. So there's been a moment where you've just gone, and so this is current energy for some of you. You're in this space, and the blood moon does that, where you're in the space where you're like, fuck. And it's the tower moment. And this is for some of you, Leo, where, and I love tower moments. Do I love them? I do. I love them. Is that making me call them in? Spirit's like, they're inevitable. Tower moments are inevitable. Tower moments force you to face certain things to move forward. And those who have tower moment after tower moment after tower moment are not closing down cycles. So I don't have a lot of tower moments. However, if you are pushing yourself to do something big, that's like two, three levels up from your current energy field, you will go through many tower moments because that is the process. When you do big things, you get the tower moments because that's you shifting. That's why I say when I love tower moments, what I'm saying is that I know that I'm shifting. And I also take responsibility for those shifts, and I take responsibility for the tower moment, and I look at it and figure out what I need to do to move through it, because I know that if I can master that, I won't get it again. And also it'll catapult me forward. That is, my friends, manifesting. The sort of Ace of Swords in reverse is talking about being brave because you know that doing this, you know that, so the Ace of Swords, so in the upright, the Ace of Swords talks about being victorious and being able to cut out people that do not serve you and things that do not serve you. And so that tower moment, the brave tower moment, was about you identifying that something that was in your energy field that was not good for you, identifying that it wasn't good for you, and it did create discomfort, but you realized it wasn't good for you. And you closed out some conflict. You closed out, you literally, by being brave, by letting that go, by not letting that consume you, you averted or you prevented yourself from going headfirst into a whole heap of conflict. I am very proud of you because you didn't go down the rabbit hole. So in perfect harmony, spirit, because you did that, because there was an opportunity for you to, like, closing out cycles, because there was an opportunity for you to go down the rabbit hole and you didn't take it because you processed it properly and you realized that actually it wasn't about something that you did, it wasn't about you being in a perpetual cycle of being treated like shit. It was actually just not for you. You prevented yourself from going down the rabbit hole. You were like, oh, here I am, head first into a freaking shitstorm. Hang on a minute. Let me look at this shitstorm. Actually, this isn't a shitstorm. This happened in order to prevent a shitstorm. So I didn't get what I thought I wanted. But what I really didn't get is that shitstorm. And because of that, you stopped yourself going over and over and over and over and cycling down the rabbit hole. Perfect harmony is clarified by the Page of Cups in reverse, the Two of Pentacles in reverse, and the World card, my friend. Okay, so let's talk about this. Perfect harmony. I couldn't have picked the best cards in the best position to clarify this for you. Page of Cups in reverse. Perfect harmony. Perfect harmony at Page of Cups in reverse. Perfect harmony. Two of Pentacles in reverse. Perfect harmony. Closing down cycles. So you've closed down the cycle. You've now closed. This is future energy. You're in perfect harmony with love or matters of the heart, and perfect harmony with money and juggling dollars. You no longer have the issue of getting shit offers of love or being in a relationship where things are constantly emotionally roughed up and money is constantly roughed up. You've actually closed the cycle, my friend. You've closed one cycle and you've created another. I'm sure I talked about the time machine, closing down cycles, generational cycles. That's what the World card's talking about. It's referring to that. The perfect harmony has come because you've closed down the cycle. And now you're no longer getting the shit offers in love or taking the shit offers in love. You're no longer juggling money. You're actually in the flow of money. And so both of those things will flow because you've closed them down. Okay? Endless possibilities for June, please, Spirit. Can we get some clarifiers for the endless possibilities for June, please, Spirit? Thank you. I'll take them. Endless possibilities for June, Spirit. I want some clarifiers before I read those. So I'm going to pull them up because I know that there is... I'm a light worker, and regardless of whether I get cards that are daunting for me as a reader or for you as a viewer, there is always light inside my stories. So you're already like, oh my God, what'd you get? Endless possibilities for June energy. Queen of Pentacles in reverse. Queen of Swords in reverse. Six of Swords in the upright. Queen of Pentacles in the upright is somebody who works hard and stacks her coin, and she is successful because she is a hard worker. That's in reverse. The Queen of Swords is someone who's very focused and gets what she wants. Hard work. You're leaving the struggle. You're leaving the struggle. The struggle that you have. This is my baby having a blast of a time yahooing and having fun with her nanny in the background. So the Queen of Pentacles in the past energy is in the reverse, is talking about hard work not paying off. The Queen of Swords is in the reverse, is talking about focused and not getting what she wants. And the Six of Swords is talking about leaving for calmer waters. So you're leaving around, you're leaving like the goals that you've set yourself up to, the struggle for money, having to work so hard for money. You're focused on the things that you want and going for them. You kept being in a position where you would leave scathed, like you needed to like leave and hurt, right? That's kind of like the perpetual cycle that you self-perpetual cycle, the self-appointed cycle that you'd put yourself into. And Spirit is like, not your fault at all. You didn't realize you had a choice of getting out of it. It was a massive shift that you did. Well done, you. But that's kind of what it was. Like, money is hard to come by. I'm very good at manifesting it, but my God, I spend my life doing it. And the Queen of Swords, whatever you focus yourself on, you just constantly, and so you're shifting away from the struggle. I don't know what they're playing, but I assure you they are cracking up laughing. And so the Two of Wands in reverse, the Moon in reverse, so clarity, Page of Wands moving forward. Wow. So the Two of Wands in reverse, that's talking about no longer being stuck. Unstuckedness. The Moon in reverse, clarity. You're moving forward in your life to a new opportunity, an exciting new adventure. This is an exciting new adventure, and it's happening in June. So you're on an exciting new adventure, Leo, and this was an honor to read for you because I just love Leo. I love the energy around Leo. I've always loved Leo, like even before I knew what star signs were, like what they meant and everything. I always just was like, Leo, yay, I love Leo. You know, like it's just beautiful. It's the whole lion thing about it. And like, hello, it sure is. Leo, I hope you enjoyed this reading. It was an honor to read for you. In the description box below, there is a link for a one-on-one. And then there is also a link for my free group where I do free readings for my members. before you pop off. It would mean the world to me. Pop off. Usually that means fart in my family. Sorry about it. Love you more than farts. Love you more than farts. Funny. I know who that's going out to. Anyway, before you pop off, like, comment, subscribe, share. It would mean the world to me. All right. I love you, Leo. Bye for now.